Well, it's been called the world's largest vaccine incentive. Aussie travel giant Luxury Escapes offering 200 million in vouchers to anyone getting the jab before the end of September.
And CEO Adam Schwab joins us now from Melbourne. Adam, thanks for your time this morning. This is a huge incentive. Why are you doing it?
We just want to help with the vaccination drive. And ultimately, Australia's got two problems. We've got a supply issue that's getting better, but we've got a demand issue as well. And we can't help with supply, but we can certainly help with demand, just to a small extent. And while we're a travel business, the goal of this isn't to help our business. The goal of this is, can we get Australians vaccinated as quickly as possible?
You know,
we can do to help.
Yeah, and there's all sorts of countries doing this. I think in the United States, they're doing some kind of lottery. And this one, you want to do a voucher scheme. How will it work exactly?
You're right, Carl. We wanted to make it super easy. And our business is making travel easy. We wanted to make this promotion really easy. So you literally go to the Luxury Escapes website, you click on the promotion button, and you say when you got vaccinated, you say what vaccine you took, and you swear that it's, obviously, you say that it's correct. And then you've got your promotion, you've got your $200 discount straight away. It's less than 30 seconds. So we wanted to make it really simple and really easy.
What sort of things do you get a discount on?
It's all our international trips that are our Lux limited time exclusives, which is what we do really well. So as a business, we focus on sending people abroad and also within Australia. So obviously the vouchers are valid for any promotion outside Australia, and you've got a year to buy a package. So there's no need to rush out and buy it now, because obviously there is still uncertainty around borders. So there's plenty of time till June 30 to buy, and you've got till 37 to get vaccinated or to start getting vaccinated to qualify. So there's certainly no rush to use it, but obviously we want to try and get people to get vaccinated as quickly as possible.
Sorry, I reckon the one thing is, we've been talking about this, the people who want to travel overseas are more likely to be the ones that get a vaccination anyway. So how do you get the rest of Australia incentivized to do it?
It's a really good point, Carl. I think part of the problem is, and I know Scott Morrison's a big fan of the show, is we haven't got a target. If you look at the rest of the developed world, there's generally a target, which is usually around 50%. So when we get 50% of people vaccinated, so you've seen that in the UK, you've seen that in the US, you've seen that in Israel, New Zealand's got a similar target, South Korea's even less. So when you get to that 50% mark, well, that's not quite what we call herd immunity, but it's the point where you've got a significantly lower death rate than stuff like the flu. So we need to get to 50%. And I think the problem is a lot of Australians are simply holding back because there's no target. So what we'd love to see and what we'd love to help with is let's set a target of 50% Australians vaccinated, which is, call it, 28 million doses done. Mm. And if you look at the current rate of supply, you can probably get there by mid-October. So it's actually not that far away. But I think Australia needs a target and something to go. We need a carrot.
Are you planning on, like, a particular target? Like, you in your mind have this idea and your team have this idea that we will be back travelling internationally by October?
I think October is probably optimistic. The government said in June next year, which I think is highly pessimistic. I think they're really scared of overpromising. But I think if you look at the rest of the world, US, Europe is largely open now. We're not there yet. We don't have that level of vaccination, clearly. But if you look at when can we get to 50%, then it's really reasonable to get there by mid-October if you look at the current level of vaccination. And the fact we've got 3.5 million Pfizer doses landing in July and August, we've got Moderna coming in September, we've got plenty of AstraZeneca supply. So supply is actually becoming less of an issue. At the moment it's an issue, but in a couple of weeks it won't be. The issue is going to be demand.
That being said, I mean, literally 3.2% of the Australian population have been vaccinated. You must be fairly concerned that you're not going to reach those kind of levels. And the government's not likely to set a target when they're not 100% sure on supply.
You're 100% right, Carl, and I think we've got to trust. Pfizer's been incredible at hitting their supply targets since they started coming in March. So Pfizer's actually been really reliable, and they've always said they'll ramp up in July to 3.5 million. I think Greg Hunt said this last week that Pfizer's going to ramp up. So that the ramp up is absolutely coming. Moderna's coming September. So I think we'll get there on supply. And I think he's got to trust that it'll happen. You're right, we're only at sort of 4% now, 3-4% now, but 27% first dose. And the second dose ramps up really quick. We've got AZ second doses coming now. And we've got, I'm getting my second dose. I'm leaving the studio, going straight to the convention centre to get my second dose now. So we're getting our second dose, should be ramping up really quickly. That's what we saw in the US and UK. It was a slowish start, and we've been a bit slower, but it was a slowish start, and they really ramped. So I think we're about to hit that inflection point right now.
I think
you're
right. I hope so too. Look, Ali and I will have our second doses tomorrow. Does that mean we qualify for $200 off a Luxury Escape?
Absolutely, Carl.
Okay, perfect. Give us the codes, and we'll be away. Good on you, mate.
Thanks,